shoulder arthroscopy instruments. These instruments are very delicate and it should be protected very well by putting it in specialized case. This is suture retriever. It is used for management of sutures in between the portals. The tip should be blunt so that while retrieving the suture, it should not damage the suture material. This is soft tissue grasper. This is used to pull rotator cuff tendons while doing cuff repair or capsulolabral structure while doing bank cut repair. This is rasp. It has a serrated tip. There are two rasp, upward rasp and downward rasp. Both of them are used to create a bleeding bony bed for better healing of the soft tissue. While doing rotator cuff repair, it is used to create a bleeding bed over the footprint area. And while doing bank cut repair, it is used on the medial surface of the glenoid for better healing of the glenoid labrum. It can also be used to remove the spur from the undersurface of the acromion. These are tissue elevator, also known as the tissue liberator. Similar to the upward and downward rasp, there are upward elevator and downward elevator. It is used to remove the fibrosis and for better mobilization of the soft tissue. These are used in the bank cut repair, slap repair and the rotator cuff repair for mobilization of the cuff tissue or the capsulolabral tissue. This is the standard probe, which is around 2 to 3 mm wide tip. And there are markings over the probe for measurement of the retraction of the soft tissue. Compared to the knee probe, the length of the shoulder arthroscopy probe is slightly longer. This is knot pusher. This is used to take a sliding knot to push the knot inside the joint. Ideal knot pusher should have a blunt tip. If the tip is very sharp, then while pushing the knot inside, it may cut the suture material. This device is known as the bird beak. It has a sharp tip. It is used to pass the suture material from a soft tissue. This is the straight bird beak. There are other bird beaks also of different angles. This is upward shaped bird beak. Similar to the previous one, it has a sharp tip, but it is curved upward. This is left side curved bird beak. And this is right curved bird beak. This is known as the suture cutter or fiber wire cutter. The fiber wire is very strong. And it requires a very sharp cutter to cut the ends without the fraying. And these are Wisinger rods. Usually you should keep two Wisinger rods. These are used to create a portal and switching the portals in between. The tip should not be very sharp to prevent the soft tissue damage. This is cannula inserter. It is also used to dilate the portal. It comes in the various size. It fits with the slot of the cannula and it is rotated clockwise to push the cannula inside the portal. This is a direct suture passer. Suture from the anchor is loaded on this device and this is used to grasp the tissue and then take a bite to pass the suture from the cuff or the labral tissue. This is used to settle the suture from the soft tissue. It comes in the various angles, left, right, straight, 25 degree and 45 degree curved. This comes as a disposable or autoclavable device. Thank you.